Either that was a little tune called Rigodon, which I've written recently during the lockdown. What I'm going to play this morning is eight of my own compositions, most of which were written during this very strange period of isolation. And then I'm going to finish off with a sonata by Beethoven. Now, this is the 250th anniversary of Beethoven's birth and a big celebration, but unfortunately, the coronavirus has put its big foot through a lot of the concerts. So it's really nice to be able to combine some of the outcomes of this pandemic with some of the music of Beethoven. A rigodon, which I've just played, is basically a fast-running dance from the Renaissance period, and the feature of it is that it never stops. So now I'm going to play another piece inspired by Renaissance and Baroque music, and it's a saraband, which is a slow Spanish dance in three. It's very slow because King Philip of Spain decreed that it should never be done fast because he didn't like those fast and salacious dances that were going on in the time. This is quite a grave and mournful piece. It's a saraband movement with two variations.
Thank you.
So that was the Saraband. I'm now going to play one which is a little brighter and jazzier and funkier, and it's called Round Dance. I wrote this a couple of years ago, and I had lots of tunes that have been going over my head for years and years, and when thinking about them, I wanted to combine them into a sort of mashup, which I guess is what this is, and a bit of a round dance, because like life, it goes round and round. Things happen, things stop, things come to an end, things start, and the piece reflects that round dance.
Thank you.
the round dance. And now I'm going to play something a bit more reflective. This is a nocturne. A nocturne is a night piece. Chopin and John Field were the people who pioneered the form, but it's basically a very still thing, representative of the night. And at the moment, it might be representative of people's insomnia, although this was actually written a couple of years ago, Nocturne. That's an nocturne. The next piece was written in August, actually in July, and it's a quadrille. I was thinking about Lewis Carroll and the lobster quadrille, and I wondered what the music might have been like. So I thought something a little bit plaintive with a constant rhythm. So here is a quadrille. Thank you. Sunday quadrille. Next one, also from the summer, is a little samba. I wrote a couple of Latin American numbers, and this is a samba beat, Frostlight Samba. Again, I think a little nocturnal and probably sleepless. Like samba. Just a quieter one now, Barcarolle. This is a gondola song. Again, this was written last year in 2019, and I was thinking about Venice and gondola trips, and again, something quite hidden by darkness, I think. So, Barcarolle. And in fact, this is written, it's dedicated to memory of my teacher, Alex Kelly, who was the head of piano at the academy. And I wrote it for, there was a celebration to celebrate what would have been his 90th birthday. So I played it at that for the first time.
Thank you.
you very much. Thanks for listening. I'm going to bring my performance of my own pieces to an end now. Going full circle, this is a piece called Furient, and I actually wrote it back in 2000, very first term I worked here at Rugby. So this takes me back. It was a very, very rainy year. It's from a suite called From Rainy Days, because as far as I remember, every day it rained. This is Furient. Beethoven Sonata in F minor, opus 57, which is called the Appassionata Sonata, which is the Italian for impassioned. I think if you were to play just one piece by Beethoven, one piano sonata, maybe this would be a very good example of some of the very special characteristics of his style. It is, as its name implies, very impassioned, but it's also as a lot of Beethoven is, made up of very simple musical ideas. In the first movement, it's just made up of arpeggio, which I think everybody who's started the piano from grade two would know what an arpeggio is. And Beethoven doesn't write a big tune, he just uses that arpeggio. It's what he does with it. This is absolutely stormy, it's full of massive dynamic contrast and restless. There's three movements altogether. The first one is a large canvas with the same tune used most of the way through, but lots of very special effects on the piano, which were completely new at the time it was written. Second movement is a very serene set of variations in D flat major, using the old trick that Beethoven liked of starting with an extremely slow melody and embellishing it gradually, first into quavers, then semi-quavers, then demi-semi-quavers. And the third movement, which is a rondo, can I describe it as funky? I think that's a really, the first funk piece I've ever come across, I think, well before the 1970s, really makes a lot of use of beat four. One, two, three, four. It does a lot of that stuff, and very exciting. Anyway, Appassionata. Thank you. very much. Thank you. See you soon. All the best.